is gone.
You both know what's at stake here.
There isn't much road left.
Take the bloody shot.
The expectations of this movie are incredibly high. We want this to be a special Bond because it's a very smart, very articulate, well-crafted film.
How we use sound in the film, and again, this is indicative of all Sam's films, it is all about supporting story. What you see in the frame isn't necessarily what you're going to hear. And that doesn't mean it's all stylized, but it means that he will make choices, bold choices. Music's very important. He's extremely musical. And he works very hard with the composer. He's with him, obviously, during the scoring, but a lot of spotting, a lot of working through mock-ups ahead of time.
As a filmmaker, he's very good at sonically having you focus on what he wants the audience to focus on without a bunch of extraneous sounds, which is also good, you know, and some filmmakers take that approach. If there's a sound there, it's for a reason. If the sound's not there, it's for a reason. And that's an interesting way to work because we're used to filling in all the colors. And sometimes you're just trying to draw the audience's attention to something and then taking a realistic, organic sound and just altering it enough to where the audience would feel it more than actually hear it.
Cornerstones of any Bond movie is all these exotic locations that he goes to. And in this movie, we travel from Istanbul. We have a chase on top of the old bazaars, thousands of years at least old. And then all of a sudden, we find ourselves back in London. We find ourselves in Turkey along the coast. Then we go to Shanghai, we go to Macau, back to London, and then back to the beginning for Bond in Scotland. And each one of these locations had to have a characteristic feel to it. But I have to say, it turned out great.
The score is a big player in this movie, and it's a fantastic score. Thomas Newman, without question, hit it out of the park, and it was a daunting task because the Bond thematic aspects of the score are always a key component to a Bond film. How our sound effects integrated with that music was really important, and really being able to let that music stay clear, all the melodic lines not be obscured by sound effects, but clearly there are places in the film where sound effects have to drive and take over.
Sam likes to use sound emotionally, and there's a scene in the film where we transition from a lot of action and violence into calm, and we used waves as a transition to do that. And we used real waves that we had recorded, but in order to get kind of the aggression into the more almost hypnotic effect, because you wanted to pull the audience right into Bond's mindset quickly. And we did that more than once during the film with certain transitional sounds, which was really fun to do.
The effect scenes or the sound scenes in this movie, they come in all shapes. And I think one of my favorite little moments is very simple in one way. A garage door goes open. Visually, we see Bond's car. All of a sudden, the classic Bond theme comes up, and then we cut to the car starting up with that classic British DB5 sound. And that's one of those moments when you go, I mean, how simple is that, right? But the hair on your back goes up. So that's not something that we worked, how are we gonna do this? That's just one of those that the combination of the picture, the story, music, and our stuff just comes together like beautifully.
I am very satisfied with the dynamics of the track, and there is such fantastic quiet in the movie and opportunities to get very much into the characters. And I love the fact that Sam believes in his movie and trusts his actors to the degree that we don't have to spice everything up and create energy, that the scene plays onto itself. And that to me is very special.
I was really excited about working on a James Bond movie because I've loved them. I've seen every single one of them multiple times. And everybody on the team brought the best. So it's at the end of the day when you sit back, when you're done, and you play it straight through and you go, that's pretty sweet.
Some men are coming to kill us. We're gonna kill them first.